Leader, Panchamrita. Here. There's been condemned in Shastras. Watermelon is very much condemned. Galanjam na bhakshayet. There is a shloka also for that. Watermelon is very condemned. But still, what I want to say is, minimize them or don't adopt them at the time of your pujas and auspicious occasions. So, this is the Anna Niyama. Second thing, Anna as a candle. What is it? Anna as a candle. What is Anna as a candle? Anna supplies two energies. It has two containers in which we can supply positivity or negativity. We can mix poison with food. We can mix drugs or medicines with food. We can mix mantras with food. Food is compatible with four things. One is kriya, that is abhichara, shunya and other things. It can easily be adopted by food. You can spoil somebody by food very easily. We can give you marana, mohana or bhedana. You can attract a person by giving some mantras in food or mixing something in food. The person will be attracted, that is mohana. The person will be made a lunatic, provided he is not before. That is bhedana. And third thing is marana, closing the person's chapter. Then it is done by people, it is done by close friends. I used to interpret the close friend is a person who closes his friend or closes the doors whenever he sees the friend. So, this type of food is so susceptible and vulnerable to negative inductivity. So, we can give drug, we can mix poison, we can mix it with mantras, we can give with any evil sorcery or deed by which the impact will be easily absorbed inside. Likewise, we can do good things also. We can improve sneha, we can improve preeti, we can improve bhakti, we can give solution and salvation also. That is by positivity adaptation. There are two stories. Yadav Prakasha is the Acharya for Sri Ramanuja. And he was just a lizard in his previous birth. And when the Paishacha means there is a demonic attribution or attrition or possession for a royal princess. Then Yadav Prakasha went there for doing some exorcist work, exorcism. Then that particular spirit told, "Hey Yadav Prakasha, how you have attained this Brahminhood and Vedic knowledge? I know that you may not be knowing. You are like just a lizard and you are just crawling in the remains of a Vaishnava's foot. And due to that contact by a great Vaishnavite, devoted, scholarly person's remains and your just contact with them has made you to be a Brahmin and a learned scholar. So it is the benefit of contact of good person's food. And Rishi Sringa was a born celibate and totally he is avert. He is feminophobic, like androphobism, that is feminophobism, he is afraid of women. He does not know anything at all. And he refused to come out of that forest. Then the people who wanted to bring Rishi Sringa to the kingdom, for wherever Rishi Sringa he steps, there will be rain and prosperity. So they planned to bring him, but he refused. At that time, they invited a few prostitutes who were available there, and they asked the prostitutes to prepare some food. And through some Rishi Kumaras and some people who are closer to Rishi Sringa, they made that food to be served to Rishi Sringa through them. After taking that food 3 or 4 days, voluntarily he accepted and he came to that place. But that was used for some good purpose. For any good food and its influence, the first is example. To change any mind, the second thing is example. If you are so vulnerable, if the inducer is so capable and potentiable, certainly this transformation will take place. If it is not taking place, either you may be not compatible or the person may not be competent. So between competent person and compatible person, certainly a mega transformation can take place with food at all. I am giving food in our ashram for several months, no transformation is taking place. Only few transformations have taken place in me. So, this is also possible. This thing is also possible. And one more thing what we are willing to say is, Sajatiya Vaividhya, Vijatiya Vaividhya. In the world we are having various differential status of food. We are having non-vegetarian, we are having fishes, and we are having egg and other things. We are having various types of foods we are having. Follow that. So, what is Vijatiya Vaividhya? Means different options of food. Because to maintain food security and distribution, God has given different options of food. And even within that, Sajatiya Vaividhya, even in the not prohibited things, even in the acceptable things, there are a lot of varieties. I want to say, there are a lot of pulses, cereals and various things available, grains available. Only few things are very much focused, accentuated and used. That is also the reason for lack of food security and lack of food proper distribution. Why scarcity is there? Because all lands are not uniform. God has given sorghum, maize, pearl, millet, innumerable things are there. They can grow, each and every land has its own crop. There is no land given by God where there cannot be crop. It is useful for some purpose. So these alternative systems, these alternative grains are not used by people at all. Everywhere they are dependent on rice or wheat. It is not there. Then vegetables, eating fruits, all these substitutions are organized, balanced way of food is not there. So we have alternatives of fasting, limited eating, we have alternatives of taking alternative cereals and pulses, we are having alternatives of taking just vegetable sauce and other things, just fruits and other things, suitable to all landforms where we can cultivate them, produce them more. As everybody is focusing on a single thing, there is scarcity, there is unadaptability, the land is also being eroded, land positions are mismanaged. There is an inherent design for each and every land to potentialize or to vivify certain crops. That thing is being mismanaged by over-exploitation or over-cultivation or over-consumption. This should also be understood by people. And one more thing I want to say, I have told you also in diabetes lecture, diabetes is a crime, punishment, or diabetes is a curse that is given by Mother Earth and nature. Diabetes is a punishment. You see, I want to say something. Technology, you have invented everything. There is a big blow to technology. Human being is born to walk. Technology, what it should have done? It should have done the natural mechanism of a body to develop its enzyme, to digest everything, and to be potentialized without walking. That has not been done. They have invented automobiles. So transportation to human beings, body should be processed by hard labor. And there are two things. Either you must develop energy in rest, or develop energy in work. Work, it is known as udyoga, rest, it is known as yoga. Developing energy by work is known as udyoga. Developing energy by rest is known as yoga. And now, lot of people are working, but no rest. And most of the people are taking rest alone, not work. How these people will survive in the world? So, the body, it is refusing to adapt the ingredients and to digest them and to assimilate them. Now we are seeing that everybody is born diabetic. Everybody is born with three things. Loan of Mother India, the inheritance of all the mistakes of their parents, the third thing is diabetes. So these things are like Kavacha Kundalas for Karna, each and everybody is born with these things. Debt, diabetics and destiny of the parents, three D's. So we are born to work, we are born to work, we are born to bend our back, we are born to walk, we are born to climb everything. Now there is lift, everything is there, you are not working at all. Intellectual work is not a proper work. Divine intellectual work is entirely different from unilateral intellectual work. Unilateral intellectual work does not bind soul with you. What is the difference between intellectual work in IT industry and the same intellectual work in Vedanta Vichara? One, it is connected with soul. This intellectual work is connected with soul. Whenever you are doing these things, naturally the body accepts something. I want to say about Pancha Shakti. What is it?
Pancha
Shakti. There are five Shaktis which most of the people may not be knowing. One is Vardhani. Second is Parivartani. Third thing is Daini. Fourth thing is Karshani. Fifth thing is Poshani. What is the power of this first energy? Even if you consume, you are saying that